You're watching Jake and Amir, but I bet you're just looking at Jake.
Wow, low self-esteem.
Yeah.
Not another scroll, dude.
Top 10 First Date Ideas by Jacob
Hurwitz. No, use your own name.
Number 10.
You sick fuck, use your own name.
Where and when? Let it be her call, it is 2011 after all.
It's actually 2012, and right off the bat, first up on your top 10 date ideas is sort of a cop-out, so you don't have to choose one.
Number 9. Feeling wine.
Not that good of a joke.
Take her to a wine bar, and not a place that's close, go real far. And not in a plane, drive in a car. That's right, go to wine country, Napa Valley, California together.
Great, so on your first date, you want to take a cross-country drive with a stranger and then spend several days in wine country with them? That's like a 9-day excursion, buddy. Stop doing that.
Number 8, take your mother on a date. The first chick you were inside of and you didn't even call her. Now that's baller.
That's disgusting.
Lucky number 11. Change your name to Kevin.
Weird. Not a date.
Meet her in heaven. That's right, a Romeo and Juliet group suicide so you can spend all of eternity together.
Why do you write everything on these scrolls? Like these ancient treasure maps you seem to have.
6 stands for chicks. That's right, it's the year 2000. So wherever she wants to go, you make it happen, Cap'n.
That is the second time you've 1 gotten the year wrong and 2 avoided choosing a date spot.
High 5. Smoke a bowl and roll. Wake and bake and make her make you a steak. You're ingesting weed and ecstasy, and guess what day it is? Xmas Eve.
Have you done that before?
Yes. Number 4 is a city so nice they named it Rice. Rice, Texas.
Another road trip?
You actually fly in through Dallas. It's a hub.
Fine.
Number 3, will you marry me?
Too much, too fast, way too soon.
I don't need an answer tonight, but I do need a promise in writing that you'll love me forever.
It's more than an answer. That's a contract.
All marriages are arranged, if you include destiny.
I don't.
Number 2. Darling, it's always been you. Please say I do. I have a rabbi, a priest, and a mosque on standby.
That last one's not a person. By the way, these are all still first date suggestions, right?
Honestly, I'm just trying to get laid.
Bad way.
Number 1. You are the one.
Okay.
I'm down on one knee, and this is my plea. You are the prettiest girl that I ever did see, so you ask that lady, will you marry me? Well?
Well what?
Well, thoughts on the list?
Why do you do this? Why do you stay up at night in your apartment making these weird lists? And you know what, even if you get some kind of perverse pleasure out of writing the list, why bring them to work and read them to me when I don't like it?
Great, so a simple yes or no would have sufficed.
It actually wouldn't have sufficed because you said, thoughts on the list? That's not a yes or no question.
And? What are your thoughts on the list?
It's a bad list. It's a bad list, and you're a bad person.
Wow, that was unexpected. I honestly thought you loved it.